What's up, everyone? It is 9 o'clock, or almost 9 o'clock. We're gonna get started here. Thought I might play some 32x games this week. It's been a while since I played some 32x, and I got my original Sega Genesis out. I can't play 32x on my Mega SG, so as good an opportunity as ever to do this. Let's cut over to my webcam. We'll talk about some of the games we got on the docket. Hey everybody, so hope everybody had a good week. It was a pretty wild week, especially if you follow the stock market. Don't normally talk about current events, but the what's been going on with the GameStop stock is quite a wild story. I definitely recommend checking that out, just from a sheer fascination standpoint. It's kind of an interesting thing. But I got a few games we're going to cycle through this evening. They're arcade-based games. First one of the night is going to be Afterburner, from Yu Suzuki. Afterburner and one of the other games I got here, Space Harrier. These are a couple of Sega's superscalar titles that they put out in the arcade. I actually have a book back there, way up there, that silver thing back there, that kind of talks about these two. They're kind of part of Sega's, really part of Sega's arcade history. And one of the things that the 32X really did pretty well was get a few of these arcade ports. Like with most of my 32X games, they're all cardboard. They're all in these clear plastic cases. I showcased them when I was playing Paprium a couple of weeks ago, but they really do protect the boxes. I mean, this copy of Afterburner is in really good shape, in part due to the fact that I put it in one of those acrylic boxes and have had it in there pretty much since I bought this copy. What else can I say about this? They were part of Sega Superscalar series. There was a version of Afterburner and Space Harrier, for that matter, put out on Genesis. They were titled Afterburner 2 and Space Harrier 2, but they weren't quite arcade perfect. And these didn't necessarily get there, but they got pretty close. Like, they got pretty darn close to being that level of what you saw released in the arcades. These came out in 1994, I believe, early 1995, like right before the Saturn came out. But these games came out in the arcade much earlier. They came out back in the 80s. But arcade hardware at the time was still so far ahead of what the console could put out. The idea of an arcade perfect game was kind of still... They were still searching for that. We really didn't start to get there until we got into the Saturn and the Dreamcast era. Quick look in the back of the box side. I do like to show that off. And quick look at the cartridge. 32X games, they had kind of their own styling when it came to the cartridge. They didn't have an end label. So a lot of people have made their own. But the cartridges themselves were kind of unique in their styling. Without any other kind of delay, let's go ahead and pop this in. Get started.
Sega.
Sega. This game is really hard too. Like, I'm not gonna beat this. But we'll play it and see how far I can get. Play it on extra easy with the maximum number of ships. We'll see how far things go. Let's see. X, speed low. Y, speed middle. Z, speed high. A, roll. B, missile. C, Vulcan. Okay. By the way, I have it back behind me. This has got one of the best soundtracks on vinyl that I own. Get ready. It's a really fantastic vinyl. Motion sickness might be a thing, too. Uh-oh. Oh no, I got shot! Very fast-paced game. Refuel. I have no idea what's happening. I'm just pressing buttons and trying to dodge rockets. Now, oh, I died. I died big time there. Now, this game in the arcade, it came in a sit-down format. And it was meant to really kind of immerse you in the game. Obviously, you could not do, like, barrel rolls and stuff, but, I mean, you did have a joystick, or a flight stick, I should say, and it was pretty cool. No, I got shot! I don't have that many ships left. Oh, we got so close to the refuel. I thought I got shot there. Well, there I did. No! That it? No! They took me out! No! Got a game over. Hey, Donut. Wow. I'm finally able to stop by the stream. Well, thank you for stopping by. And we're playing some really fast-paced Sega arcade games tonight on the courtesy of the 32X. Now, there's kind of an example of what you had in the arcade. You had that flight stick capability. It was really cool. Music, again, is very on point. Oh, you can continue.
Get ready.
Why not? Let's see how far we can get. If they're gonna give me continues in this game, I'm gonna use them. I don't know. I don't actually know how many levels there are. Oh, wow. I just got destroyed there. No! I just ran into a rock. I wasn't sure if the game would let me do that. Clearly I was wrong. Yeah, what the? Well, that's game over. That was a little harder than I thought. RIP, yeah. Way down at the bottom. Let's see where it's going to start me. Oh, back at stage 5. Let's see. I mean, that's on extra easy. The difficulty of this game really ramps up.
Get ready.
Let's try that again. Refill and go. Idea really what's going on right now. I'm pressing buttons wildly trying to stay alive, and I got blown up. Oh no! I'm out of missiles! Ah! I don't know what I'm gonna do without missiles. Ah, it's so hard to navigate that. Oh my gosh. This might be my upper limit. There we go. Got me. I'm dying a whole lot in this game. They keep putting me at the on the score chart though. Even though I'm right at the bottom. Well, we got to the next checkpoint, so that's something. I don't know how many levels there are in this game. This really must have been a quarter muncher, though. No! Darn it! Breaking right. What do you want from me? Ah! We made it. We made it to the next checkpoint. Do multiple barrel rolls. We're gonna pull some sick G's here. And I'm dead. Couldn't take it. Too many G's. Holy smokes. I'm running out of missiles. Uh-oh. I made it. I made it to the checkpoint. Easter egg, that's the Outrun car. You're right there. No, I died. Well, we made it to the next checkpoint. We're progressing.
Get ready.
Let's get ready. There's so many ships. I have no missiles, and there's just ships everywhere. All right, thank you. Checkpoint. I thought I got shot there. No, I don't like these missions. I can't dodge the walls. Uh-oh. No! This is better. I'll take this. I just don't want to run into anything. Uh-oh. No! I'm dead. Well, darn it. How far back is that gonna set me? Wait a minute. Oh, okay, whatever.
Get ready.
Wait, 13? It sent me all the way back to 13? Oh, this is awful. I don't know if I can recover from this. Actually, I'm just impressed that I made it from level 13 to 18. Down. Five, no. I do wish that the Vulcan machine guns were more useful in this game. Because it's like, once you run out of missiles, you're kind of on your own. There. Well, I'm just going to use my, There we go. Uh-oh. No! You said break right, I broke right, and you killed me. This isn't good. I made it! Yes, I made it to level 19. I got missiles. We're gonna be okay for about 30 seconds here, and then they're gonna kill me immediately. Like right about. Fire all of the missiles! No! I think I got one more life. Yeah, I've got... Survive! No! Oh... All right, I made it to level 20. I made it to level 20, I'm happy. I got a medal. All right, where's it gonna start me? Stage 19. I got a checkpoint. This is excellent. Let's see how far I can get now. Uh-oh. Get off my tail! Darn it. That missile's like, break right, break right. So I break right and I still get shot. Gotcha. No. All right, checkpoint. Are there? Fire all of the missiles! I'm out of missiles. This can only end in tears now. Yeah. Oh. I made it to level 23 right as I died. This game is a lot of fun. Like, it's so intense and fast paced. It's fun to just play it for like 30 minutes or so. All right. We'll give this one more go, then we'll switch games. But again, there was a version of Afterburner on the regular Genesis. It was called Afterburner 2. But it never quite... It wasn't nearly as good as this. Like, because the Genesis really couldn't do this... Keep up with this. And I wish I still had that version to compare it. Because this is much closer to arcade perfect than... The Genesis version ever. It doesn't even compare. Uh-oh. No! No! I got shot! I mean, to some extent, I don't even really know what I'm doing when it comes to dodging missiles and stuff. I'm just like, fly as wildly as you can and hope nothing hits you. Because it gets so fast-paced. Uh-oh. I have no missiles. I have no missiles. I'm dead. I died. No! Darn it. Well, that's the end of me. I'm racking up spots on the leaderboard, though. Okay. All right, we're gonna swap games. I got a few of them. One of them again will be Space Harrier. Mainly because these games are really good arcade games. They're fun in short bursts. But it is kind of hard to play them for a full 2 hours. Or full 2 hour stream. Last look at the box of Afterburner. Really, really good box. It's just one of the cardboard ones. The manual, you can kind of see it in there. I'm not going to get it out. It's just black and white. It's nothing too impressive. And most of the 32X games came in these types of boxes. There were a few that were compatible with the Sega CD that came in long boxes. And those, I don't have any of them. They're mainly just FMV games, like Night Trap and... there was a version of Sewer Shark that supported it, but I don't think it ever came out in the US, and I think it's actually kind of rare. If I remember right. But there's a few others. They're really just kind of junky FMV games. Unless you like FMV games, then definitely check them out. They're kind of an acquired taste, the FMV stuff. Unfortunately, that's what a lot of people remember the Sega CD for, when there was really a lot more to the Sega CD. So next game, it's not going to be Space Harrier. I'm going to break that up. I'm going to bookend the stream with two good games. What's not a good game is Cosmic Carnage. So this is a fighting game, and I think it's exclusive to the 32X. Sega put it out. It's just it's a janky, bad fighting game. That's really all I can say about it. It's visually pretty. It's pretty impressive for the Sega 32X. It's not good. So this is gonna kind of be a bad game. But I like to showcase bad games from time to time. There's the side. There's the back. You know, again, it is a cardboard box like most of them. This one, the box is a little beat up inside. The cart or the box itself, the tray is kind of beat up. So it's got these flaps. They're supposed to hold the cartridge in place, but these flaps tend to bend backwards over time. And this one has done that, so it doesn't, the cart doesn't quite sit right in the box, and it kind of slides down. You can kind of see the manual in there. It is a black and white as well. I do have the registration card for this one. I got this one at the same time as Space Harrier and Knuckles Chaotix. I paid $30 a game or something. I mean, the games themselves, on average, I mean, it was like $100 or something for all three of them. Which felt pricey at the time, but is much more expensive now. Sega 32X games are just crazy for the quality of them. Because not a lot of them are really good. I mean, some of them are kind of good. But for the prices that you have to pay for some of these nowadays, I just skip it. Like, the Sega 32X is really just kind of one of these novelty things to history that I would forego unless you're, like, a really big, big, big Sega fan. Because you can have fun with so many other things. Light years away. In an uncharted star system, an incident of epic proportions has occurred. and banish the crew of an intergalactic prison barge en route to a celestial mine, has overpowered their captors. During their rebellious assault, most of the ship's controls and life support systems were severely damaged. For days, the barge drifted aimlessly through space. The renegade crew realized this is going too fast. I can't read this fast. So some stuff happens. That's all you need to know. And now they're going to fight. The carnage begins. By the way, I mentioned these guys last stream. This is a local brew here in town for me. Two Plumbers Brewery. Magic Potion is the name of the beer. Take care of your small businesses. They really need it right now, especially like your local restaurants and bars. They offer takeout. They do those types of things. You want to stay safe. Definitely find a way to support your local businesses. Keep your local community in mind, especially during these times. All right, so I'm gonna drop the difficulty all the way down because this game is, again, it's really janky. It's not good. It's not good at all. I mean, there's all kinds of slowdown. I don't know how the slowdown. No! Let go of me! I got the reach! Can't touch this! I'm just gonna smack you with my tail! Uh-oh. I'm taunting! No! I died. But look at this. There's slowdown, there's zoom in. It's like, what is that? Like, I can't even see what that is. Oop. Okay. Guess we're fighting already. Stay back. I don't even know what that is. Let go of me. Gotcha. This is just all kinds of jank. I mean, look at this. The slowdown in this game is just unbelievably bad. I mean, it looks all right. Oh, can I cheese this? If I can, I'm just gonna cheese it. Oh yeah, we're cheesing this. We're cheesing this. Flawless victory. I am not sorry for that. Not at all. Whoa, hello. Ow! It's set up. You can't dodge it. Oh, I can jump. No! Stop! Stop it with the dodges and the things. There. Enough of that. But the slowdown! The slowdown! Like, there should not be any slowdown in a 2D game on the 32X. Like, it's so poorly made. I'm just gonna cheese this as much as I can. In a way, too, it's kind of got the fighting vipers. Yeah, I just perfect that. It took me all of 5 minutes to figure out how to cheese bosses, or to cheese enemies in this. I'm not sorry for this. If the game cannot deal with this, I'm not sorry at all. I've never been able to do this in a fighting game before, where I just spam the one move and just, like, it can't handle it. The AI cannot handle it. The game is just so broken. Oh. It's trying. The game is trying. I don't think it's going to work, game. Unless you can dodge this. There we go. I don't feel bad. I don't feel bad at all. Not at all. I don't feel bad. Oh, he's got his, Mighty Morphin Power Rangers going here. Uh-oh. No, stop throwing me. I've got the reach. You can't touch this. There. This is a bad fighting game, everybody. It's a very bad fighting game. Soul Calibur, Virtua Fighter, this is not. Hey now. Can't touch this. No, you don't. There. Be gone. I just want to point out this guy's name is Naruto. I don't know if I can cheese this one. Hey now. Oh, I thought I died there. No! No! I died. You got me. Now. Ah! There. Got him. Hey now, that's cheating. You can't do that. That is definitely cheating. I call hacks. There. There. The AI still cannot keep up with that move. Like, it doesn't know what to do when I spam that move. Okay, now I'm gonna fight, like, the evil mix of the alien and the predator here. Hey now, let go. Let go! No, let go. Okay, I don't like this. Let go of me. Oh, gosh. Wow! Okay. Apparently, I don't have the reach advantage either in this fight. Well, okay, we'll do that. I still don't know what I did there. I kind of activate that just randomly. No, you let go of me. There. Got him. Stop it with the stuff. Oh. All I know is like one hit moves right now. So I just have to cheese it. What is guard, by the way? I don't even know what like guard is in this. This is not going well. No! Let go! No! Got him! Oh, what is this? I just barely survived somehow on that one. This is the last battle, I think. Stop blocking everything! Ow, ow. What is that? No! No! Uh-oh. I died. Ah! This is awful. I lost to an ant with a six pack. No, you can't do that. This is not going to end well. Uh-oh. No! There. Surviving. We're going to round three, everybody. Remaining life, 001. Greedy. I gotta make distance. There. All hail the giant snake monster. I think I won. I won the game, everybody. Nausea wins. You are the winner of the carnage. However, the ship exploded before you escaped. If only you had finished them faster. Oh, that's hilarious. I love it. I absolutely love that. You won, but you still died. So, normally I talk about the game while the credits are playing. It is, it's not a good game. It's not a good fighting game. It's kind of got a charm to it, but it's not a good game. It's got slowdown. It's got these weird zoom-in things with the camera going on. The moves aren't particularly interesting. Granted, I'm not very good at fighting games, but you know, it's not a good game. Nope, not at all. It's a unique game, that's for sure. Cosmic Carnage. Special thanks to... I mean, visually it's not bad. It's not too bad visually speaking. But the slowdown is really kind of unacceptable for this type of a game. And the, you know, I kind of shifted a little bit. One second here. There we go. It's not really, music's all right, but the gameplay just isn't there. The gameplay is really just kind of, and I'm not the best at fighting games. That's why I put it on super easy, but it's really mediocre overall. Sega. All right, we'll play another round of this. Sure. I mean, the armor system is kind of cool. No! No, you're not supposed to be able to do that. Oh, come on. I died. That did not go as planned. And now I'm getting laughed at. Okay, so I think I kind of figured out Naruto, how to play Naruto. No, not that Naruto, but this Naruto. He's got this, like, dash ability that you're really supposed to make use of. That's it. I got cut in half. Oh, the gore! I didn't know there was gore in this game. Holy smokes. Yeah, there is. I didn't do any of that to my enemies. It's like mix and match costumes. I don't like that. I don't like that grab. This is not going well. I'm not landing any hits on this right now. Might have to change characters. Naruto is not gonna work. I surrender. Mm-hmm. yeah, that's the end of me. But then there's so much slowdown. Like, it's just too much. There's too much slowdown in this. My mic seems to be going crazy right now. If I can bring this down just a little bit. I'm gonna let myself die. I'll try a different character, because Naruto is a fail. You are a failure, Naruto. I am very disappointed in you. Hey, what time is it? Okay, we got all kinds of time. It's only 10:10. Let's play the creepy alien predator monster and see what happens. Okay, this character is all kinds of jank. I'm gonna die. I died. I still lost. I lost! Like, I don't know the point of really these zoom-in attacks. It really... I mean, it's kind of impressive visually, but it really kind of breaks the flow of the game. No, let go of me. Let go! Stay away. I'm turtling. No! Draw! Oh no! Come on. I'm playing for keeps here. There we go. Alien Predator Hybrid wins. Oh wait, we got a final round. You in the corner, what are you gonna do? No! That's not supposed to happen. Oh, come on. I'm gonna stay away. No, you stay away. I win. I win! I'm not sorry about that. Not sorry at all. I'm gonna lose this one. Okay. Maybe this character is better matched against Xenolan. Whoa, okay. You're not supposed to be able to dodge that. There. But the slowdown, there's not, that slowdown is really bad. Talmok. The names of these characters. Uh-oh. Hey now. I'm not actually doing a lot of damage to him, and he's crushing me. Oh! Nicely done. He's just like, enough of this. I'm doing, like, no damage to him, though. What the heck? Why am I not doing any damage to him? Hey, you got me. That's a rip. Oh. Well, now I died. Oh, wow. That's kind of brutal. This game's only rated T. That's quite a bit of gore. Like, look at that blood spurting out of my arm stumps and everything. All right. Ooh, there it is. I died. Okay, we're gonna take a quick 5 minute. I'm gonna come back, and then we're gonna play Space Harrier and close out the night. Thank you. All right, I am back. Let me cut over to my webcam. There we go. Hey, everybody. Next game, or last game of the night, is, of course, Space Harrier. This copy, I mentioned it earlier, I got this with my copy of Cosmic Carnage and Knuckles Chaotix, and they're all, Space Harrier is a really good game, Knuckles Chaotix is a pretty good game, though some people don't like it because it's not really a Sonic game. Cosmic Carnage, of course, is a bad game. but, you know, it's an interesting game release. It's an exclusive release for the 32X, so it's kind of neat. Afterburner, this was part of the Sega Superscalar series, and it was made by Yu Suzuki. It came out in the 80s. It had a flight stick, as I recall, as well. It was another very popular game, a game that got a release on the Genesis, but really didn't feel like an arcade perfect port. So it's kind of another one of these quick burst type games, because again, it is an arcade port. It's a black and white manual. The Sega, the 32X, all it ever came with was black and white manuals. I don't know why Sega really kind of tried to cheap out with a lot of this, and this might have to do with the fact that Sega of Japan really didn't care about the 32X. They looked at it, they looked at it as really a novelty that as far as I know, Sega of America really pushed for, because they didn't want to give up on the Genesis just yet. And I don't know if I agree with that. I still kind of respect the 32X, even though I never got any games or got a few decent games and never really got a great library. Because I think it could have been great. It could have been a really good piece of hardware if only Sega had not abandoned it in 6 months in favor of the Saturn. And the Saturn is fantastic. I love the Saturn. I do think it's got flaws. The Saturn, if they had delayed it, Sega with the Saturn, as I pop this in, Sega with the Saturn, they really wanted... Well, let me go ahead and start Space Harrier, and then I'll continue on with my monologue there. Sega! So Sega with the Saturn, they really... They tried... What am I trying to say? The Saturn was built for 2D games, and the 32X was also kind of built for 2D games. What Sega should have done, by the way, this is another beer from Two Plumbers. This is a brown ale. Interesting to note, this pairs best with space westerns. Space Harrier is kind of space western, isn't it? Kind of? A little bit? A little? I don't know. But, let's see, we're going to play on easy with max players. I still believe if Sega had Sega thought the Saturn, the market was going to be with 2D games primarily for another generation. If Sega had been smart about it, because they missed. Initially, they missed with the Saturn, with the idea of thinking that the Saturn was going to be a 2D first platform. If they had recognized correctly that the market was moving towards 3D, which it was, during the development of the Saturn, they should have delayed the Saturn release and used the 32X to kind of float that. Instead they rushed the Saturn out, and they really shouldn't have done that. Because they were very much afraid of the PlayStation, and the decision to the decision to release the Saturn on a, like a surprise day at E3 really was a mistake. The games weren't ready. So a lot of them came out and they started looking kind of bad. And it kind of tainted everything. It hurt Sega's image with retail. Whoa. Okay.
Get ready.
Yeah, they should have delayed it. Like, they should have delayed it, like, maybe 6 months, the Saturn. And even if the Sega 32X, like, even if they had only, like, sparsely supported it for, like, maybe 18 months, it would have gone a long way. Because there was some interesting third-party games also in development for it. Like, there was a Castlevania in development for the 32X. There's a few other oddities as well. Virtua Hamster. What else was there? There was a Sonic game, in fact. Not Knuckles Chaotix, but it was like Sonic Mars or something. I think that's what it was called. And I mean, they could have released that as well. Oh, I died. I mean, there could have been some things they could have done.
You're doing great.
There we go. They just didn't, they did not plan that well. And because of that, the 32X is kind of a, it's kind of a failed thing. Even though the hardware itself had promise.
Get ready.
Get ready. It's so fast. Gotcha. Easy is kind of easy. Whoa, hello. Oh. Ran right into that. What am I doing? I don't know what I'm doing right now. I'm killing trees? Is that what I'm doing? Sure. Hello. Whoa, hello. No!
Get ready.
Uh-oh.
You're doing great.
Okay. Mammoths! No!
Get ready.
No! It's not game over. It can't be. Sega. Oh, I can continue.
Get ready.
Welcome to the Fantasy Zone. Oh, that was close. No!
Get ready.
Whoa, hello. Kill all the mammoths! No!
Get ready.
Uh-oh. No! This level's hard. Whoa!
Get ready.
No! I won!
Get ready.
I won that level! Oh, what?
Sega!
Okay, we still got like 15 minutes. We're doing fine. Oh, I gotta play stage 6 all over again? Okay, fine. Uh-oh. Whoa, serious?
Get ready.
Uh-oh. No!
Get ready.
Not doing so hot. Oh my goodness.
Get ready.
Well,
get ready.
I did worse that time. I didn't even get to level 7. I'm all the way at the bottom.
Sega.
Welcome right. to the fantasy zone. Get ready.
Doing good. No.
Get ready.
You gotta be kidding me.
Get ready.
All right, we made it to level 7 again. Stop it! Stop shooting at me! Boss fight. Oh no.
Get ready.
Whoa, stop! Okay, we made it to stage 8. Now this is where I get destroyed. Like that. I ran into a tree.
Get ready.
Well, don't tease me like that, game. I'm gonna have like carpal tunnel after this. Because these are games, again, Space Harrier and Afterburner were made for a like a flight stick. Like you're supposed to be doing this. This, it's not made for this. It ain't made for it. Nope, not at all. All right. Oh, stage 6? What? What is this? Okay. Let's start over. Because stage 6 is gonna kill me.
Get
There we go. Got him. Trees! Oh.
Get ready.
Okay. I don't think I killed that boss. I think I just flew right by it.
Get ready.
And I died again. My goodness. Stage 3 is just destroying me. Whoa.
Get ready.
Game over. Hey, I got top 2. I'm owning the top 5 now.
Sega.
Sega. I think I gotta turn this down a little bit more.
Welcome.
Look at me.
It's
all right. Get ready. We'll do this one more time, then we'll call it. I just want to play some 32X for the night. It's been a while since I played 32X. Hello. There.
You're doing great.
Bye, dragon.
Get ready.
Oh.
Get ready.
There. Got him. The trees! Look out for the trees! Ah! I knew I was gonna hit a tree. Got him. Oh.
Get ready.
Walked right into that. So much speed. I still don't quite understand this. But I got a lot of points for it, so... Sure. You stage six. Whoa. Darn it. That was a good run. Well, I own the top five.
Sega.
All right. Call it there. Just wanted to play some of my, my 32X games. The 32X is kind of weird because it doesn't really have a lot of games that you can play for a long period of time. There are a lot of quick burst games in the 32X library. There are a couple of them that, you know, that maybe have some longevity to them. Blackthorn is one of them, but that's very expensive. Like, it's a super expensive game. Most of the 32X, the good, decent 32X library, it's stuff like Space Harrier, Afterburner. Knuckles Chaotix is another one that kind of has some longevity to it. About 4 or 5 hours, I think, on a long play. But, yeah, the 32X, it's a good piece of hardware. It was good. In a way, it was a good idea. But like a lot of things Sega did, they didn't execute on it. They didn't really plan to keep it around for very long, which kind of hurt them in the market. It hurt them with consumers. It hurt them with developers that were developing games for the 32X. Like, the 32X really should have been a better system than what it was. But it's still got a few decent games. A few decent things here and there. It would be neat if there would be some homebrew indie titles for the 32X. I would definitely buy that. But don't know what I'm going to play next week. It might be... Might be another Genesis game, might be another Sega CD, might be a Sega CD game. Really not sure. I might move on to a different platform. I'm not quite sure what I'm feeling like right now. But until then, have a great weekend, and I'll see you all next Friday. Night, y'all.